today we are going to discuss about humerus. Humerus is the only bone in the arm. It has three parts. It's a long bone, upper end, shaft and lower end. This is upper end, this is shaft, this is lower end. Upper end consists of head, neck, greater tubercle, this is greater tubercle, lesser tubercle, the smaller one is lesser tubercle. In between two tubercles you have intertubercular sulcus. This is intertubercular sulcus. Greater tubercle, lesser tubercle, intertubercular sulcus. Head. This is rounded head of humerus. The side determination points of humerus are head should face medially. You know, towards your body is medial aspect, so head should face medially. On the lower end, this fossa is known as olecranon fossa. This olecranon fossa should be on the posterior aspect. This is anterior, this is posterior. The olecranon fossa should be on the posterior aspect. Head should face medially. The olecranon fossa should be on the posterior aspect. Now we discuss more about upper end. Upper end consists of two neck. The neck immediately after the head is anatomical neck. This is anatomical neck. The neck that connects the head upper end with the body is surgical neck. This neck is known as surgical neck. Anatomical neck, surgical neck. Head, anatomical neck, greater tubercle. The greater one is greater tubercle, smaller one lesser tubercle. In between two tubercles you have intertubercular sulcus. This depression is known as sulcus, otherwise known as bicipital groove. The tendon of biceps passes through this groove. So this groove is known as bicipital groove or intertubercular sulcus. Bicipital groove or intertubercular sulcus. Below the two tubercles we have surgical neck. This constituted part is surgical neck of humerus. So upper end parts are head, which is rounded one. Immediately after head you have anatomical neck, two tubercles, greater tubercle, lesser tubercle, intertubercular sulcus and surgical neck. The head is rounded and off sphere. It articulates with glenoid cavity of scapula to form shoulder joint. The head articulates with glenoid cavity of scapula to form shoulder joint. Now we are moving to shaft. Shaft has three borders and three surfaces. The rounded one is anterior border, towards head is medial border, opposite to that is lateral border. Anterior border, medial border, lateral border. Three surface, anteromedial surface, anterolateral surface and posterior surface. Anteromedial surface, anterolateral surface and posterior surface. Three borders, three surfaces. Anterior border, towards the head is medial border, opposite to that is lateral border. Three surfaces, anterolateral surface, anteromedial surface and posterior surface. On the shaft, on the anterolateral aspect, you can able to feel a roughened impression. This roughened impression is very, very important. It is known as deltoid tuberosity. This roughened impression is otherwise known as deltoid tuberosity, where your deltoid muscle get attached. This roughened impression is for deltoid muscle, so it is named as deltoid tuberosity on the anterolateral surface of the shaft. On the posterior aspect of the shaft, you can able to see a groove. This groove passes spirally, so this groove is known as spiral groove. Also, this groove consists radial nerve, so this groove is otherwise known as radial groove, spiral groove or radial groove. The area above the groove gives attachment to lateral head of tricep brachii. The area below the groove gives attachment to medial head of tricep brachii. So this groove is very, very important. This groove is on the posterior aspect of humerus. Groove is known as spiral groove or radial groove, where your radial nerve is present. We are moving to lower end now. Lower end has many features. On the anterior aspect it has rounded structure. On the lateral aspect, capitulum. This rounded structure is capitulum. Near to that you have a pulley like structure known as trochlea. Rounded structure is capitulum, pulley like structure is trochlea. This is capitulum, this is trochlea. Towards the head is medial aspect, so this condyle is medial epicondyle. This is medial epicondyle. Opposite to this lateral, so it is known as lateral epicondyle. medial epicondyle, trochlea, capitulum, lateral epicondyle. The area above the trochlea is coronoid fossa. This depression is known as fossa. The area above the trochlea is coronoid fossa. The area above the capitulum is radial fossa. The area above the trochlea is coronoid fossa. The area above the capitulum is radial fossa. On the posterior aspect, this bigger fossa is known as olecranon fossa. This fossa is known as olecranon fossa. So the following parts of lower end are from medial to lateral: medial epicondyle, trochlea, rounded structure capitulum, above the trochlea coronoid fossa, above the capitulum radial fossa, and lateral epicondyle. On the posterior aspect, olecranon fossa. Now we will discuss about the important attachment. This is lesser tubercle. Lesser tubercle gives attachment to subscapularis muscle. Lesser tubercle gives attachment to subscapularis muscle. Your surgical neck is winded by axillary nerve. Your surgical neck is winded by axillary nerve. This tubercle is lesser tubercle, which gives attachment to subscapularis muscle. Your deltoid tuberosity gives attachment to deltoid muscle. Lower end, it has mini articulation to form a cubital articulated elbow joint. So capitulum and the radial fossa gives attachment to radius, and your trochlea gives attachment to ulna of forearm to form elbow joint. That's all about humerus.